So in elementary particle physics, we have the particles that were discovered a long time ago, like the electron and the proton and the neutron. And then there's this extra particle, the neutrino. One of the easiest ways to talk about where the neutrino fits in is the beginning with the origin story. People were studying for the first time radiation of any sort, you know, Madame Curie, radioactive elements. One of the nuclear decays that was studied at the time was radioactive beta decay, and it's the breakup of a nucleus into another nucleus and an electron. If that were to happen with just two particles, the electron should always come shooting out with exactly one energy. But in fact, many different possible energies were observed, which could be understood by some of the energy being carried away by a very lightweight particle, and that's the neutrino. Neutrinos are produced by dozens of different sources. All the radioactive elements, all the radioactive sources on the Earth, every nuclear reactor, every star. We definitely see the imprint of neutrinos when we look in the cosmos and look at the patterns that are there in the sky. So we know neutrinos are out there, and there's a lot of them.